हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग। इन टुडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू सी वाटर जेट मशीनिंग प्रोसेस। इट इज अ नॉन ट्रेडिशनल मशीनिंग प्रोसेस वेयर वी आर यूजिंग अ टूल व्हिच इज अ जेट ऑफ वाटर एट हाई वेलोसिटी एंड प्रेशर टू मशीन मटेरियल्स। एज दिस प्रोसेस इज सेम एज अ वाटर इरोजन फाउंड इन नेचर, बट it is greatly accelerated and concentrated. It is a true cold cutting process where we are not getting no heat affected zone, no mechanical stresses will be developed and environmental hazard. It is not limited to machining, it has a used in a food in the food industrial applications. It is a machining process which is a fast, flexible and reasonably precise. So in this session we are going to see water jet machining process. For that we are going to see the principle of this water jet, what is the equipment and how this process is work, that we are going to see. Then application where this water jet machining process is used, that we are going to see. Then last one, that is merits and demerits, advantages and disadvantages of this water jet machining process. Before starting to this session, I request all of you to subscribe my channel and click on bell icon to get more notification, as I am preparing educational videos. So if you want any topic to be covered, put it in the comment box. So first one is the working principle of water jet machining process. In this, water jet machining process involves the use of high velocity and high pressure thin jets of water to cut the job, where this high pressure water jets come out of the nozzle, it gains a large kinetic energy, and this large kinetic energy it converted into pressure energy which induces high stresses on the material, and these high stresses, if they are surpasses the ultimate stress of the material, then the removal starts. So working principle of this water jet machining is what? A use of high velocity and high pressure thin jets of water is used, and it's bombarded on the work contact surface of the workpiece, and there this water cut the job. So this is the principle. Now guys, we are going to see the equipments used in WJM, that is water jet machining. So first one is a fluid supply. It is used for storing the water that is to be used in the machining operation. Second is a pump. It pumps the water from the reservoir. So whatever the fluid supply is having, from that it pumps the water. Then third one is an intensifier. It is important. It is connected to pump and it pressurizes the water acquired from the pump to the desired level. So whatever the water is required for the pressure, high pressure, this high pressure can be gained by this intensifier. Then fourth one is the accumulator. It is used for temporary storing the pressurized water. It is connected to the flow regulator through a control valve. Then controls. It controls the direction and pressure of a pressurized water that is to be supplied to the nozzle. Then valve. It is used to regulate the flow of water. So if you want to regulate the flow of water, for that we are using this valve. Then last one is a nozzle. It renders the pressurized water as a water jet at high velocity. From that nozzle, the jet of water is coming out and it is fall on the contact surface of the workpiece, and then the operation is performed. So these are the equipments used in water jet machining process. Now guys, we are going to see the working process of this WJM. First one, the water from the fluid supply is pumped to the intensifier using hydraulic pump. Then this water, this intensifier increases the pressure of the water to the required level. Usually this water is pressurized to 200 to 400 megapascal. Then this pressurized water is transferred to the accumulator. The accumulator temporarily stores the pressurized water Then this pressurized water enters the nozzle by passing through the controls and valves. As there is no moving parts and no maintenance cost, this nozzle which is used, it is made by the sintered diamond and tungsten carbide, which having the exit diameter about 0.05 to 0.35 mm. So from that small exit diameter, the high pressurized air is coming out. So the it expands, the tremendous increase in the kinetic energy which is coming out the water jet, and high velocity water jet produced by this nozzle. And this high water, high pressure and high velocity water jet is used to cut materials such as wood, coal, textiles, rubbers, rocks, concrete, asbestos and leather. So when this is coming out, this water jet strike the workpiece and stresses which is induced. This stresses, if we are getting greater than the ultimate stress, then the material removal from the workpiece is started. And this work, whatever the water is coming out from the workpiece, it again drain out and it filtered out, and again that is supplied to the fuel supply. So this is the working process of water jet machining operation. Now we are going to see one animation. So in this you can see the water is coming from the nozzle with a high pressure and high velocity. It cuts the stone with a precise and accurate manner. So this water is coming out with a high pressure and do the machining operation. And this nozzle is made of sinter diamond and tungsten carbide, which having a small diameter of 0.05 to 0.35 mm. Now this water jet machining is used in a cake cutting, plastic cutting, foam cutting. It can be used to manufacture printed wire board. Also it is used in a fish meshing. It is having some merits that here we are using a water for cutting, which is cheap, non-toxic and readily available. The water jet keeps the job clean and dust free. The only moving part is the pump, therefore the operating and maintenance expenses are low. The process is very safe to use as we are using a water jet, so there is no harm to the operator. Very complicated designs and detailed work can be done. There is no damage of the workpiece due to thermal stresses. Very little heat is generated. Soft materials like rubber can be cut through this process where saw teeth gets clogged. If you are using saw for cutting the soft material, then on the teeth the material is clogged and the cutting will not be getting properly. But if we are using this water jet, then we can cut the material very easily, that softer material, and the whatever the chips which are formed, that will not be clogged. It will be drained out very easily. Then demerits: hard materials cannot be cut. For cutting the hard materials, we required higher pressure. So to overcome that, nowadays we are using abrasive water jet machining process, where the abrasives which are having 0.45 micron size is mixed with the water and compressed to some pressure, that is 420 megapascal, and it is passed to the nozzle and strike on the workpiece surface. So there we can cut the material. So these hard materials can be cut with the application of abrasive with the water jet. Also, it is having a high initial cost for storing reservoirs, then intensifier, accumulator, pump. The cost is more. So in today's session, we have seen water jet machining process, that is non-traditional machining process, which using a water jet to remove the material from the contact surface of the workpiece, with the application of high pressure and high velocity, the water jet strikes on the workpiece and material removal is taking place. So if you like this video, please stay connected and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you. Thank you very much.